Hi, I'm Glen from Southern Graphics in the UK. So this month we're taking a look at the ProPen 3D by Wacom. As an ambassador, I get to use all of their products as they come out and we test them in the studio. The ProPen 3D, same as the old range really, it's a ProPen, it's useful with lots of the Wacom devices. We've tested it with the MobileStudio Pro and the Intuos line as well. And it is a very, very useful pen for someone who is heavily involved in 3D. So we got the box and we opened it as you do for an unboxing, and we get the wonderful pen, we get the case, and there's obviously spare nibs, both the felt and the plastic ones that you'll be familiar if you're used to using a Wacom pen. Obviously instructions and warranty, and you get a wide range of coloured rings as well to identify your pen in the studio so no one else steals your pen. So the big thing, the new front button, a total of 3 buttons now, and we lose the eraser on the back of the pen. So it's almost exactly the same specs as the ProPen 2, same sensitivity, same accuracy, shares the same coloured rings and the same size of rings, and the case and the stand. But it seems to be, it's actually 5% thinner. It probably feels a bit more than that because it's got quite a thin profile. And it's got an anodized aluminium body, so it feels better in your hands overall with that little bit of a thinner profile, which just makes it feel a little bit more professional. So the main reason that this pen's come along is for 3D applications. It has software features such as pan zoom, navigating 3D scenes to tumble, and tumble emulating orbiting in some of the CAD packages. Having the button on the pen at the front is much more user-friendly than having an eraser that you can click on the end of the pen. And that allows it to be used a lot more without having to stop the way you hold and grip the pen. With the eraser button, you would literally have to stop doing the function that you're doing to call it and either flip it for an eraser in 2D. It can be used in non-3D applications. But some of those features are just not going to work, such as the tumble. So the Wacom software allows each of the buttons to be configured as we would expect, pretty much to suit the application that you want to use. And the settings are going to change from application to application. So how we set ZBrush up will be different to how we set Cinema 4D up. The default configuration for the buttons is as follows. So you have an upper button for right click, a middle button for dual function, pan and zoom, pans when hovering the pen and clicking, and zooms when the pen is pressed down. And the new lower button is a tumble. The default configuration is designed to emulate the SolidWorks navigation controls, as it's the most widely used navigation type in 3D applications. Software that does not use this navigation setup will need to be configured manually. In the example video here, we're using ZBrush. We've set the top button to tumble, the middle button to pan and zoom, and the new bottom button. We set that to one of the most well-used features in ZBrush, which is keyboard B or keystroke B, and that's for brushes. And you're always calling brushes, so that's the most useful one for me at the moment. This pretty much shows the brushes, and I change those all the time. And I do put keyboard shortcuts in, and I do remember the keyboard shortcuts, but it's nice just to click it and see those brushes in front of me. It quickly changes, allows you to jump into the menu they want. And again, that can be configured to anything that suits you. Final opinions. So what do we think of it? So far, really, really enjoyed it. It's made me use the pen more with other applications. It's useful in the programs that we've tested it in. We're going to continue to use it with programs like Maya, and we'll perhaps have a look at something like 3D Studio Max. And overall, it's a really good addition. It isn't groundbreaking. It doesn't change anything fundamentally, so you'd be annoyed with it, unless you're a user that really uses the eraser. And I'll be honest, I don't know many people that were really that enamored with the eraser. So overall, you probably will have a good experience with it. See what you think. Try it with your 3D packages, and it may become your most used pen.